Vanessa Seelert, and I am the director of the Lionel Hampton School of Music here at the University of Idaho. And I would like to welcome you to the 2017 Carmine Caruso competition of the International Trumpet Guild. It's been an exciting day here, and you're about to hear some more great trumpet playing. And right now, I would like to welcome to the stage the director of jazz studies and one of our professors of trumpet, Vern Seelert.
Good evening. Really glad to see all of you here tonight. We had a great day listening to the five finalists. They're from all of the United States, and one was from Europe. And they each played a set, and they're going to play one tune each tonight. This tune was selected by our adjudicators. And without further ado, we're going to bring out our first finalist. His name is Bruno. Calvo, Anillo. He is from Cadiz, Spain, and currently living in Amsterdam. He's going to play a piece by Sonny Rollins called Airegin. Please welcome Bruno, Calvo, Anillo. And playing with him tonight, I think that's totally out of order. I'm sorry. I should have brought up the trio first. You want some people to play with, don't you? On the piano, from Seattle, Washington, please welcome John Hanson. On the bass, also from Seattle, Washington, Michael Glynn. And from Bellingham, Washington, on the drums, Julian McDonough. Once again, this is Bruno Calvo-Anillo.
Thank you. Are you all awake now? So we are having an absolute blast. My name is Sean Butterfield. I'm the other trumpet guy here at U of I. And this gave you a great taste of what we've been enjoying for the last 2 days. These finalists have been fantastic. Our guest artists have been fantastic. We just could not be having a better time. So Bruno, Calvo, Anillo, our next finalist, is going to be playing the Herbie Hancock Classic, Driftin. This is Josh Shpak from Boston, Massachusetts.
please, a big round of applause for Justin Copeland.
this month. And our next competitor is from New York City. He's going to be doing Hoagie Carmichael's Stardust. This is David Neves.
Thank you.
please another hand for this amazing rhythm section. They've been working so hard. Our last finalist is originally from Portland, Oregon. He currently resides in Eugene, Oregon. Please, a nice warm round of applause for Tony Glausi. Thank you.
why our guest has had such a hard time this afternoon. It has been awesome. So, we are going to take, I was supposed to say this. That was Tony Glausi original called In the Beginning. Fantastic tune. So, we are going to take a quick 15 minute break to get the big band set up, and we will see you back here in 15.
Thank you.
tenor saxophone from Seattle, Washington, Steve Tressler. And on the alto saxophone, also from Seattle, Mark Taylor. We've had such a blast with our adjudicator judges. Super great people, fun to hang out with. The first person that we're going to bring out is a jazz studies professor at Indiana University. Prior to that, he was at Cincinnati Conservatory. Please, a big hand for Pat Harbison.
Yeah. Good noise.
artist judge was the winner of this competition way back in 2003. I think it was held in Florida that year. Wonderful trumpet player, incredible writer, and he's got a great TED talk that you can check out. Very cool. Please give it up for Cleveland, Ohio, by way of New York, or the other way around, New York, by way of Cleveland, Ohio. Dominick Farinacci.
Hello, everyone. It's such a pleasure to be here tonight, and today was just a real special inspiring day to hear so many talented young artists playing at such an incredibly high level. Definitely look forward to getting back home and getting into the practice room so we don't start losing gigs. So that's good. And thank you so much for inviting me to be a part of this. It's kind of surreal to be in such incredible company here in terms of the history of this wonderful event. We'd like to play a song for you that I wrote. I just want to tell you just a little bit about it. To put it in context. So I wrote it during 3 years when I was living in the jazz capital of the world, Doha, Qatar. Yes, that's usually the response I get. Like one person claps, silence, and like awkward. What the hell are you doing out there? So anyway, Doha is in the Middle East, next to Saudi Arabia, about a half hour flight from Dubai and Abu Dhabi. And I was there as the global ambassador for Jazz and Lincoln Center. They had a lovely venue out there. And 6 nights a week, we were playing and invited artists from all over the world, particularly from around the region. And it was a very special moment in my life to be able to collaborate with great artists from different areas, Lebanon, Iraq, Syria, different North African countries. And there we were, night after night, collaborating, learning about each other's music. And as we know, as artists and lovers of music, the special relationships that music and the arts build across cultures. And so I decided to write a song that was based on my experience there. It's kind of an interesting and wild place. On one hand, it's built on very conservative religious values, and on the other hand, it's kind of this cosmopolitan, very diverse place. It's one of the most diverse places on Earth. It's a transit hub for all kinds of places around that part of the world. So it was an interesting kind of clash. So one night I slept out in the desert, I rode a camel, and then the next day I came back and I wrote this song. For those of you who haven't ridden a camel before, I suggest you do it before you, after you decide to have kids. This is a little bumpy. But other than that, it was a very soulful place and we met some beautiful people. So we'd like to present this song to you called Doha.
Thank you.
Dominick, Farinacci. That was Mark Taylor on the soprano saxophone. Yeah. Our third and final artist adjudicator has been a member of the Lincoln Center Jazz Orchestra for the past 24 years. He's directing me today. Wonderful player. We're going to do his arrangement of a beautiful Wayne Shorter composition entitled Armageddon. Please welcome to the stage Mr. Marcus Printup.
Thank you.
We invite back the artist, Adjudicators, one more time, and they're going to play something very slow and pretty for you. Please, once again, Pat Harbison, Dominick Farinacci, and Marcus Printup.
Thank you.
Harbison and Marcus Jenkins. So I'd like to bring out a very good friend and colleague, and I just have to say it's great to have him here. Putting on something like this would be really hard if you were by yourself, and luckily I am not. I have a trumpet colleague. He is way more organized than I am. Just put that out there, which is a good thing. I just want to say a big thank you to Sean Butterfield for all his work on this. Please welcome to stage Sean Butterfield.
Helping us with submissions. He's out in Oklahoma and he had to do this all from there. So
really appreciate the mic and support for all of this. So we're going to sneak in. Can we get another round of applause for these finalists? And then so with that, we're going to bring up some of the ITG members, and I'm going to introduce the president all the way here from Australia. Brian Evans is going to be here, and he's going to do the announcement of the winners.
Competitions have no place for music. The music's not a sport. Perhaps they have a point sometimes, but there's no denying that competition plays a big part in musical careers. Try telling someone in orchestral audition that they aren't competing for anything. That said, if we focus just on competing, then we quickly lose sight of the real goal, and that has to be the music. If we're not focusing first and foremost on that, we're missing the point. After that, we have just to let the music speak for itself and leave it in the hands of those who are judging, be it the audience, audition panels, or adjudicators. Today, we heard excellent examples of music first from five great solos. The trumpet didn't get in the way once. Yeah. I do pity the judges in their task of deciding, of course. May I also add that, along with creating great music, one of the other important goals is to be a good colleague. Getting along with your fellow musicians is a crucial element in sustaining a long career. Even in competitions, I find that kindness and generosity outweighs all other elements, and I'm sure today's finalists have displayed excellent camaraderie and generosity of spirit, something that will hold them in good stead as they go out into the world of professional music. Before I put them out of their misery and announce the results of adjudicators' deliberations, I want to thank a lot of people. Not all of the ones that Sean has just done, but firstly, the ITG Board of Directors for their wise decision in granting the hosting duties of this important competition to Van Seelen and the University of Idaho. There'll be more of that in a minute. Thanks again. Thanks again to Grant Peters, the Caruso Competition Advisor, for his attention to the competition and support of Vern and the team. In case you don't know yet, Grant becomes Vice President and President-elect of ITG on the 1st of October this year, when Kathy Leach becomes President and I fall back one position. So it's going to be a great couple of years, 46 years ahead of Grant, which will have a great bunch of fun, I'm sure. So, of course, we must also thank UI, the Lionel Hampton School of Music, Vern, Sean Butterfield, and their team of volunteers for mounting a wonderful event. Today is the culmination of many months of preparation, and I'm pleased to see they are still smiling and still friends. Next, let me add my thanks to the fabulous trio of John Hanson, Michael Glenn, and Julian, birthday boy with Don. We've worked so hard supporting our finalists and people. That includes extensive rehearsals yesterday, and truly, we at ITG love to work our jazz trios to death. But they're always so wonderful, and these guys just fit into that mold perfectly. Also, full praise for the Palouse All-star Big Band. Thank you. and our final judges are here with us and deserve further praise. Thank you, Marcus Printup, Dominick Farinacci, and Pat Harbison. We're getting to the really important part of the thanks. As Pat reminded us in his class this morning, one other competition we trumpet players can have is with ourselves, such as that 13-year-old know-nothing kid who battled Tijuana brass trumpet parts 5 decades ago. It's really, truly special for me to be able to thank Herbert Alpert, one of my great heroes, and his foundation for their generous ongoing support of this competition. Mr. Alpert's generosity to arts organizations like ITG, is legendary, and ITG is deeply grateful for his support of this very important career launching competition. We are very proud to list him as the recipient of ITG's highest honour, the Honorary Award, as well. And we are certainly extremely proud of and grateful for our long and successful relationship with the Alpert Foundation through the Carmine Caruso Jazz Trumpet Solo Competition. Thank you for everything, Mr. Alpert. And now it is time to get the serious part of the proceedings. You've all been waiting for this. So I don't mess up like the recent awards thing. you're all in the right? So no further ado. Results of the Carmine Caruso International Jazz Trumpet Solo Competition and recipient of $5,000 USD prize is Bruno, Calvo, Anillo.
Yeah. You need those guys.
Yeah.
Thank you.
trumpet, Calvo and Anillo. Tony Glausi. Harbison, Dominick, Farinacci. And the band. Thank you. Have a great night. Take care.